Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to make what you see on the screen right now. This tutorial is mostly about the reactor nose that I had seen on Lazy Artist tutorial. So this is inspired by him. I'd like to show my viewers. They're called ShaderToys. If you're not familiar with Reactor, I'll go through this right now with you and we'll start out with a little introduction of a couple of them and then I'll show you what to do to download it. So we'll go to Fusion. For those of you that don't know me, I have to use this on-screen keyboard because I'm paralyzed, can't use my hands and arms. I put that out there every time just because people wonder why I have the keyboard on the screen in the way. So with that said, we'll go ahead and get started. So I'll show you a couple of them now and then I'll show you what to do after you download it. The link for the reactor nose will be in the description below. After you download the reactor, all you type in is shade and they'll come up. There's a whole library of them, which I'll get to in just a moment. Some of these, all you have to do is merge it in to your media in. Some, you have to connect the media in to it, like this one. And in the inspector, you do have some options here. It's pretty wild. I'm not going to spend much time on them for the sake of the tutorial. This is the one we're going to do the tutorial on today. I'm not going to spend a lot of time showing all of them. Like I said, there's probably 100 of them in the library. All right, now I'll show you what to do after you download the reactor if you haven't already. Go over here to Workspace. Down here to Scripts. Reactor. Open reactor. This will open. Scroll down to Shader Toys. Right here. Select it. Come down here to install. When it's done, just X out of it. Once you have it downloaded, you can go back to Workspace. Go down to Scripts again. And then Shader Fuse Browser. This will show the whole library of the nodes. They're not in alphabetical order. That's the only thing I don't like about it, but you can see a little preview of them. Screen's probably too small for you guys to see. Okay, we'll go ahead and get started. We'll go to the merge, right click, and swap inputs. Now we'll put the media in on top of the reactor. Select the media in. Grab a rectangle off the toolbar. And go to the inspector. Take the width and height all the way up. Select the media in. And we want resize. With the resize node selected, make sure you select the keyframe aspect. On height, I like 900, so it'll be 1600 by 900. Right click on the rectangle. Copy. Click away. Right click and paste instance. Grab a background. Select the instance. For those of you that don't know what an instance is, it's an exact copy of whatever node you took it off from. It's connected by this little green line, and everything highlighted in green in the inspector indicates that they're both coupled together. You could de-instance any of these values. We're going to do the solid only. So right click on solid. Down to de-instance. Now we'll uncheck the solid. We'll take the border width up to 0.02. Or set yours to your liking. We'll select a background. Pick a color. I'm going to use a color picker and pull mine off the background. On the instance, we'll right click, copy, click away. And paste another instance. Add a merge. We're going to de-instance some more stuff here. Right click on position. De-instance that one and length. We'll right click on that one. Copy. Click away and paste instance. Add another merge and another background. Let's make this color a little more visible. Right click on the background. Copy, click away, and paste instance. If you select the last instance, if you look in the inspector, you'll see the position and length are still coupled to the one we pulled it off from. So we'll de-instance both these. If you move the position, you'll see in the viewer we have two of them. You can set the length to your liking. Let's re-instance the length. Just a position. That's what we want to de-instance. So we'll bring them both down to zero. You don't really have to, but we'll start out with that. Right click on it. Modify with. Atom curve. Let's go to this one, do the same. Modify with. Atom curve. Now go to the modifier up here. If you rotate the offset, you'll see they separate in the viewer. We'll set the offset to 0.5. We'll set the scale, which will be the speed of it, to 2.0. Now if we play it, see the one's faster than the other. So go back to the, which would be the third instance, and set the scale to 2. Now they'll both move at the same speed. I'll set my length a little bit lower. Select this instance, which is a background. Shift space and glow. Move that one over there. Right click. Copy. And paste instant. You can use either one here to adjust it. All you really need to do is move the blend, but if I add more glow to it, you have options there. Now we'll change the color. Go with teal, kind of goes good with the blue. Go to the edit page. We'll render the cache. We can also adjust the speed of this background. Go back down to Fusion. Select the reactor node. Come up here to frequency. You can also change the color of them, size of them. You have a lot of options. Scale. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.